And during the few moments that we have left, we want to talk right down to earth in a language that everybody here can easily understand.
Look in my eyes, what do you see? All right, let's talk about it. Well, that's a wrap. At the time of this recording, it is October 21st, I believe. Yeah, the month of October is really flying by, isn't it? But postseason is among us, and it is heating up, and it's on the AL side, it's the Yankees and Astros, big surprise. And on the other side, it's a good surprise in the Phillies versus the Padres. That series is currently tied 1-1 at the time of this recording, and they play tonight, actually, in Game 3 in Philadelphia. But the World Series, you know, it can be the Phillies and the Astros, and I'll be happy as long as the Phillies win. At the beginning of the postseason, I predicted that the Mariners would play the Mets because I'm an idiot, but that's not what we're here to talk about. We're not here to talk about the postseason that we're supposed to be in, that I wish that we were in, I should say. But we're actually here to talk about the 2022 Rangers season. Yes, I have it all written down here, and I wanted to do this video at the end of the season after we played the last game against the Yankees, but I didn't have enough time. But yes, I'm going to go ahead and do this video for you because I know that you have just been waiting so patiently, impatiently, some of you. But this video is going to be a little different because I know some of my other Ranger videos are like 35 to 40 minutes long, and I'm sorry for that. So what I'm going to try to do here is I'm going to keep this video short and simple. I'm just going to go ahead and rapid fire all these off to you and see if that makes it any better. So without any further ado, here is the recap of the 2022 Texas Rangers season. And go. Eli White made a tremendous catch out in center field early in the season, and then he got hurt and was out for the rest of the season. Cole Calhoun got really hot with his bat, and then he got really cold with his bat, but his defense stayed hot like I knew it would. Thank you, Cole. Thank God that the ship is going away next season, because I could not stand every time we had runners in scoring position and we wanted to put it on the ship, and that bit us in the ass every single time, so thank goodness it's going away. This past May was our first winning month since June of 2019. We went 17-10 in that month, and that was the only winning month of the season. Matt Busch got traded to the Milwaukee Brewers. That sucked. Willie Calhoun got traded to the San Francisco Giants. That was awesome. And then he got DFA'd, which was even more awesome. Steele Walker is a douchebag and should never be on a major league team ever again. He should be in the minors for the rest of his career. Matt Carpenter got released to the Yankees. I was really upset about that because he started doing really good for the Yankees and he could have done really good for us. Leody Taveras got much better, much to my surprise. I've always hated him because he sucks, but he looked a lot better this season. Hopefully he will continue in the next season. Woody got fired. I did not post about that at all, and I felt so bad about it, but I was going through some stuff at the time, so now I will address it. Woody, I am so happy that you're gone. I've never been more happy than this since Rougie Odor got traded. Thank you for nothing. John Daniels got fired as well. Biggest surprise of the season, but thank goodness it happened, because now we can actually move forward with what we need to do, which is successfully win games. Good riddance, John Daniels. Marcus Semien sucked, and then he finished beautifully. He had 26 home runs and 83 RBIs. Not too bad. And he only played 161 games out of the 162 in a season. Yeah, pick it up, will you, Marcus? Nate Lowe had a .303 average, which led the team, and that's tremendous. I really like Nate Lowe, and I can't wait for him to continue on with us. Corey Seager had 33 home runs. Thank you for that. Keep it going, and I can't wait to see what you do next year. Adolis Garcia had 101 RBIs, which is fantastic, led the team as well. And he's just going to get more and more powerful, and I hope that he can keep the strikeouts down to a minimum next year. Josh Young is the next big thing. I'm calling it right now. He's going to be our next Michael Young. That's actually, you know what? Let me backtrack a little bit. No one's going to be Michael Young ever again. Josh Young is probably going to be the closest thing to being Michael Young. But, you know, I don't want to jinx anything, but he's very good. I'm excited that he got that call-up and that he's showing off as he is. During the season, we turned two triple players. Here they are right now.
trying to, I don't know, deke somebody or something, but this one lined to first, right there for it is low. He'll triple touch play. First for two, and now throw it to second base for the triple play.
Runner at first base. This one grounded to third. Young steps on the base, one, on to second, two, on to first. Triple play! Second triple play of the season for the Rangers.
Good stuff, huh? Moving on. Dane Dunning sucks, and I hope that he goes away. Mark Mathias, we got him in a trade, and he turned out to be something really special. I hope that he can be with us next year and keep showing off what he can do. We signed Kevin Plawecki from the Red Sox. I'm not sure why. We already have catchers. I know one of them are good, but Mitch Garver will be back next year. So thanks, Kevin, for your help. I don't know. Aaron Judge hit his 62nd home run, his record-breaking home run for the AL record, at our turf. And you know what? That's fine. I'm not mad about that at all. Aaron Judge deserves it. He's clean. He's tall. He's fast. He's strong. So couldn't happen to a better guy. So congratulations to Aaron Judge. And I still want to know how much that that fan that caught the ball got for that home run ball. We'll never know. And lastly, Martin Perez was a stud, an absolute stud this year. He had 32 starts, 23 of them, which were quality starts. He had a 12-8 record with a 2.89 ERA, 169 strikeouts. 87 of those strikeouts were looking, which led the majors this year. So, Martin, if you could do us all a favor, please, and just re-sign and extend with us until, I don't know, 2026, 2027, we'd greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much for your amazing season. And there you have it. That is the 2022 Rangers season recap. If I missed anything, please let me know. I probably did, but those were not very newsworthy topics, I guess, for me to cover. Closing remarks, you know, we had a final record of 68-94. 8 games better than we did last year. A lot of them were due to horrible pitching out of the bullpen. Well, no, our bullpen actually did really well. It was our starting pitching that really didn't show up. Glenn Otto's looking good. Hopefully he can make the rotation next year. As I said, Dane Dunning, take it or leave it. We just couldn't get a handle on a lot of things. Injuries really bugged us down. Jonah Heim did really well. I don't know. We're looking up. That's all I can say. We're looking up. But one thing I do want to talk about, and this news just broke about an hour and a half ago, is that we, the Rangers, have signed a new manager, and that man is Bruce Bochy. I am so incredibly excited about this signing. I said earlier in the season, whenever Woody got fired, that I hope that I love Beasley. I love the man, but he is not manager material, especially for this team. He does fantastic over as a third base coach, so he needs to go back over there. Thank you for closing out the season as you did. It wasn't the greatest, but, you know, you did your job. But yes, Bruce Bochy, he is the man for this job. If it wasn't Ron Washington, it had to be Bochy. So thank you, Chris Young, for bringing this man out of retirement. He's 67 right now, I believe. But here are Bruce Bochy's numbers for his career. In 25 seasons of being a manager, he has an overall win-loss record of 2,003 wins to 2,029 losses. So he is 26 games below 500 for his managerial career. But the good thing is that recently, it was 10, 12 years ago, but he won 3 World Series with the Giants in 5 seasons. That was 2010, 2012, and 2014. So he's got quite the resume, and he has 44 wins in the postseason, which is 5th most all-time amongst managers. So, that being said, I cannot begin to explain to you how excited I am that we actually have a competent manager, the most competent since Ron Washington. And it's exciting. It's an exciting time to be a Rangers fan. So during this offseason, we've already got the manager taken care of. Great. But with all the players that we already have acquired, and hopefully we can acquire some great pitching arms, especially in the starting rotation, and a couple of bullpen additions. The sky's the limit, really. If we can get Michael Conforto out in the outfield, maybe let Brad Miller go or something like that, and bring in Michael Conforto, that'd be great. We just need pitching. That's all we need. And then if we get that puzzle piece, it's going to be a beautiful, beautiful thing. That being said, thank you so much for watching this video. I'm sorry that it took a little while to get out to you, but better late than never. I will talk to you again during spring training. And until then, go Rangers.